Very, very good evening, dear students. Myself, Akhilesh Sharma, Assistant Professor, SIITE, Bhopal, Department of Civil Engineering. Today's topic is continuity equation. Before we start continuity equations, we start the rate of flow or discharge. It is denoted by capital Q. It is defined as the quantity of a fluid flowing per second through a section of a pipe or a channel. For an incompressible fluid or liquid, the rate of flow or discharge is expressed as the volume of fluid flowing across the section per second. For compressible fluids, the rate of flow is usually expressed as the weight of fluid flowing across the section. Thus, for liquids, the unit of discharge or rate of flow are meter cube per second or liters per second. And for gases, the unit of capital Q is kgf per second or newton per second. Consider a liquid flowing through a pipe in which capital A is cross-sectional area of pipe and capital V is average velocity of fluid across the section. So then the discharge capital Q is A into V. Now we start the continuity equations. The equation based on the principle of conservation of mass is called continuity equation. Thus, for a fluid flowing through a pipe at all the cross sections, the quantity of fluid per second is constant. Consider two cross sections of pipe as shown in figure. This figure. Let capital V is average velocity at section 1-1, this section 1-1, and rho 1 is the density at section 1-1, and A1 is the area of pipe at section 1-1. And V2, rho 2, and A2 are corresponding values at section 2-2. This is section 2-2. Then the rate of flow at section 1-1 is rho 1, A1, V1 for compressible fluid. यहाँ पे हम compressible fluid की बात कर रहे हैं, यहाँ पे इसलिए हमने rho 1 से इसको multiply किया. And the rate of flow at section 2-2 is rho 2, A2, V2. According to the law of conservation of mass, rate of flow at section 1-1 or discharge at section 1-1 is equal to rate of flow at section 2-2. So we can say that rho 1, A1, V1 equal to rho 2, A2, V2. Equation 1 is applicable for the compressible as well as incompressible fluids and is called continuity equation. If the fluid is incompressible, then rho 1 is equal to rho 2. Agar hamare paas fluid jo incompressible hai, then rho 1 is equal to rho 2 and the continuity equation reduced to A1 V1 equal to A2 V2, which is also equal to discharge or rate of flow. So I hope aapko samajh mein aa gaya hoga ki continuity equations kya hoti hai. Is par based hum kuch numerical solve karte hain. So hum yahan pe ek numerical lete hain. Problem one, the diameters of a pipe at the section 1 and 2 are 10 cm and 15 cm respectively. Find the discharge through the pipe if the velocity of flowing through the pipe at section 1 is 5 meter per second. Determine also the velocity at section 2. The solutions, first of all, we write the given data. Given data is at section 1, the diameter is 10 centimeter or 0.1 meter. So D1 equal to 0.1 meter. So the area at section 1-1 is pi by 4 D1 square, which is equal to 0.007854 meter square. And velocity is also given. V1 is equal to 5 meter per second. And at section 2-2, the diameter D2 is 15 centimeter or 1.5 meter. So the area at section 2-2 is A2 equal to pi by 4 D square, which is equal to 0.017667 meter square. So first of all, we calculate the discharge through the pipe is 5, and it is given by the equation Q equal to A1 into V1. Putting the value of A1 and V1, and finally we get the value of discharge capital Q, which is equal to 0.03927 meter cube per second. So we calculate the discharge. Second is, we also calculate the velocity at section 2-2. So using equation, we have A1 V1 equal to A2 V2. This equation is known as continuity equation. We also know that. So velocity at section 2-2 V2 equal to A1 V1 upon A2. Putting putting the value of A1, V1, and A2, and finally we get the value of velocity at section 22, V2 equal to 2.22 meter per second. So I hope आपको समझ में आ गया हो कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशंस क्या होती है और हमने उस पर बेस्ड एक न्यूमेरिकल भी सॉल्व कर लिया है तो आपको क्लियरली समझ में आ गया होगा, क्लियर हो गया होगा इसी से. सो नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में हम कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशंस को देखेंगे डिटेल में, मीन्स थ्री डायमेंशनल में हम इसको थ्री डायमेंशन में हम देखेंगे कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशंस क्या होती है, उसका डेरिवेशन या उसकी इक्वेशंस क्या होती है. तो आज के लेक्चर के इतना ही सफिशियंट है. थैंक यू सो मच. सी यू इन नेक्स्ट लेक्चर.